Joe Jones there. So which party is winning the ethnic vote and what can they do to attract minority voters? Well, joining us from our Westminster studio to discuss that are the former Conservative Party candidate and broadcaster for Colourful Radio, Luana Morrison, and also the director of Black Vote, Simon Woody. Before we get started, though, a reminder that you can join the debate too. Tweet us at Sky News, including the hashtag Sky Debate. Text on 84501 or email news@sky.com to let us know what you think or if there are any points you want to try to put to our guests here, and we'll try to get through some of your comments as we go along. Let's start with Luana Morrison, a former Conservative Party candidate. We saw Joey's report there up in Hendon. And when we talk about black and minority ethnic communities, voters, it's not a homogenous group by any means. But are they being failed politically? Do they have a true political voice, do you think?
Yes, I think they do. And the Conservative Party has changed quite radically, I think, over the last 12 months. Well, even before that, because I was a candidate, and I received lots of support as a candidate. I received, you know, Women to Win also helped me as a candidate. And over the last year, we've seen a lot of new candidates coming on board who are from the BME category. There are quite a few Asian women in safe seats. There are quite a few women in safe seats. And yes, I have to confess, there aren't a lot of black women in safe seats or in fact, I don't know if they're in any conservative seats at all, but there are quite a few black men who are coming through on the conservative side. So I think they're doing... Sorry?
Do you think there are enough?
Well, there's never enough. there's never enough. But the thing is, this is not a problem that you can solve overnight. And as they say, you have to be in the game to win it. And if ethnic minorities aren't participating in the parties, and it's not just the Conservative Party who has a problem, the Labour Party has a problem, the Lib Dems have a problem, UKIP have a problem, they all have a problem with attracting minorities, either as candidates, as council candidates, as voters, or just people who engage with the political process.
Okay.
So this is not just a problem for the Conservatives, but at this point it's a little bit too late for them to start putting in place a massive wooing strategy. They, at the moment, they have to work with the resources they already have and use the candidates, the minority candidates who are now in place, to show the ethnic minorities that here we are, we're preparing the ground and we're putting a reflection of you within our party, who people who represent what you feel and what you think.
Okay, let's bring in Simon Woolley for Operation Black Vote. Simon,
good morning.
What can be done to get more black and ethnic minority candidates up there? We talked about the Conservatives, but as Luana mentioned, yes, it is also a problem for the Labour Party. Far, far fewer new candidates coming through from BME parts of the population, aren't there, in the Labour Party?
Yes. No, there is. I mean, what's critical to this debate is what you suggested at the beginning, that in a very tightly fought election, the black vote will be crucial. We've suggested that over 168 marginal seats could easily be decided by the black and minority ethnic vote. And so all the political parties need to be looking at their policies to see how they resonate, how they can address some of the concerns of high levels of unemployment.
What are those policies? They're not a homogenous group, you know, but we do lump women voters together, don't we, in the same way I suppose we're doing it here. Are there particular issues that black and minority ethnic communities are concerned about?
I think there are a number of issues. I mean, one, the big one, of course, is the shocking toxic immigration debate, which often tells people of colour that they're not wanted, even though we're a great resource in so many ways. But not only that, there's disproportionate levels of unemployment, stop and search, housing problems. So we want political parties to say, look, we value you. You're a great asset to our society, not least in your last piece, in the NHS, where minority communities work and hold up this institution with great valor, if you like. And so we need to be recognized. We need policies that resonate with the challenges that our community faces. And with often this toxic immigration debate that all the political parties pander to a lesser or more extent, it says to our communities that we don't value you.
Luana, do you feel as a community wooed by the politicians?
I don't think that the Conservatives are wooing the ethnic minorities, but I think they're addressing their concern. The Labour Party has always kind of gone off after these votes in a block. You know, they have community leaders who bring those votes to them. But Ed Miliband now wants to go out there and have 4 million conversations on the doorstep. I mean, I wish him luck with that. But the thing is, the Conservative Party is addressing the issues that the minorities have raised, like stop and search. Theresa May has brought in new rules on stop and search. They're also doing something about employment. This is one of the biggest issues in the ethnic minority community is employment. And I've been, you know, working with a lot of people recently who have been helped by the enterprise allowance schemes, by all sorts of schemes that the government has put into place. I think the Conservatives need to talk more about a lot of initiatives that they've been putting in place to help ethnic minorities and other minority groups within their lives. And they're not getting this message out, I think. And also the immigration. The immigration problem we have now, it's not about ethnic minorities. I mean, the immigration problem we have is about the numbers of Europeans coming into this country, and that's actually disadvantageous to the ethnic minorities, because what it's doing is pressing them back down to where they were in the beginning. Because before we were just beginning to feel settled in the country, and now we are lumbered together with all these new immigrants, and everyone is saying, oh, there's too many of us. But neither is the British people or the Conservative or actually any of the parties talking about immigration in terms of ethnic minorities. They're talking about it in terms of the numbers of European coming into the country.
That's interesting, isn't it, Simon? And you brought that up as well. What can the big parties do on immigration to encourage black and ethnic minority votes?
Well, I mean, the irony is that right on our doorstep, there's a deluge of talent. And what we want is to want it to be recognised, and then for that talent to have access to good education, access to top jobs in the city, in Parliament and beyond. And, you know, when you recognise the talent on your doorstep, everybody benefits. But what's interesting in this very tight political race, it's for us at Operation Black Vote and others to go out there and ensure that our communities are one, registered to vote, and that we will vote. So we'll be making demands to the political parties. This is a central demand, that you ignore us at your peril. If you recognise us and want to include us, we're British citizens, we've got a lot to offer, and then by winning our vote, you could win the election.
And it's a crucial vote for all the parties, isn't it? Simon Woolley and Luana Morrison, thank you both very much.